Good morning students, welcome back to my third lecture. So in this lecture I'll discuss about the irrational numbers. So always remember, irrational number is denoted by Q and there is a bar. So the definition of irrational number is irrational number is defined as the square roots, cube roots, etc. of natural numbers are imaginary numbers if their exact value cannot be obtained. So if we write root 21, so here we cannot determine the exact value of root 21. Similarly, we cannot determine the exact value of root 3. So these are the irrational numbers. Similarly, if we write cube root 4, so this is an irrational number. Why? Because we cannot determine the cube root of 4. There is no exact value of root cube root 4. So there is an expression, root m is irrational if exact square root m does not exist. Similarly, if we write cube root m, so this can also be irrational, but the condition is if exact cube root of m does not exist. So always remember, if we talk about the decimal representation, then the decimal representation is always non-terminating and it is always non-recurring. Non-recurring means it is not repeating. Like if we write 0.10 11 10 11 10 11 10 11 10 and so on, and it goes on, then here this decimal representation is an irrational number. Why? Because there is no repetition. Like if we write 0.333, so here 3 is repeated many times, so this is a representation of, this is a rational number. But if we write 0.10 11 10 11 10, similarly if we write 0.42434445459 and so on, it goes on, means there is no repetition and there is no prediction of the further values. So these are called the irrational numbers. Now if I ask what is pi, we represent pi with the symbol. So what is pi? So pi is the, when you draw a circle, so the ratio of circumference of the circle with the diameter of the circle is defined as pi. So pi can be defined as pi equals circumference of circle upon diameter of same circle. You all know the formula of circumference of circle, it is 2 pi r. And diameter is twice of radius, so we write as 2r. So here we will find out that it comes pi. So this is the definition of pi. You can draw the circle of any size. So the ratio of circumference of circle with the diameter of same circle is called pi. Now many of the students have misconception that pi equals 22/7. So since pi can be represented in the form of p by q, where q, that is 7, is not equal to 0, so pi is a rational number. Because we have already studied that any number which can be represented in the form of p upon q, where q is not equal to 0 and p and q are integers, are referred as rational numbers. So pi equals to 22 upon 7. But here, point to be noticed that pi is not equals to 22 upon 7. Pi is approximately equals to 22 upon 7. So how will you find the exact value of pi? So to find the value of pi, you need to draw a circle of any size. Then we have to find the circumference of the circle. After finding the circumference of the circle, that is 2 pi r, and then finding the diameter of the same circle. So when you do it, we get pi equals to 2 pi r, that is circumference, upon diameter, that is 2 r. So we will get the value 3.1415926535, and it goes on, and there is no termination and there is no prediction of the further values. So this is the exact value of pi, but generally we take pi equals to 3.14, or in the fraction form we take it as 22 upon 7. But 22 upon 7 is not the exact value of pi, it is the approx value of pi. But the exact value of pi is 3.1415926535, and it goes on, and there is no termination as well as there is no repetition. So always remember, pi is an irrational number, whereas 22 upon 7 is a rational number. Now always remember that when we write root 3 plus root 5, then we cannot solve it further. Some students write 5 plus 3, 8. This is incorrect. Similarly, if you write root 5 plus root 5 equals root 10, then this is also incorrect. Always remember, if these values are same, then root 5 plus root 5, it will be equals to 2 root 5. Similarly, root 3 plus root 3 plus root 3 can be written as 3 root 3. Or if there is a number 2 root 3 plus root 3, then we write 3 root 3. Why? Because if no number is there, that means the coefficient is 1. So that means 2 plus 1 is 3, and this is root 3. So 3 root 3 we write. Now if we have to express root 48 in the simplest form, then what we will do? We will take the LCM of 48. 24, 12, 6, 3. So we got under root 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by root 3. So we got 2 pairs of 2. So out of 1 pair, 2 will be carried out. So 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by root 3. So the number which is unpaired remains inside the root, and the numbers which are paired once come out. So here we will get 4 root 3. Similarly, 56, if we have to express root 56, then we will again take the LCM of 56. 28, 14, then 2 sevens are 14. So we will take, we will write under root 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 7. So there is a pair of 2, so one value 2 will come out and the rest will remain inside. So 2 multiplied by 7, it comes 2 root 14. Now there is a question, so that root 2 is an irrational number. So the question is, so that root 2 is an irrational number. So in order to prove root 2 is an irrational number, we have to find the square root of 2. That is the decimal representation we have to find out. So we'll place 2 here, then put zeros. in paired form. So the number of zeros depends on the requirement. So now the value is 2 here. So we have to take the value whose square comes 2 or less than 2. So if we consider the square of 1, it comes 1. If we consider the square of 2, it comes 4. So 4 is more than 2. So we have to consider 1. That is square of 1. We will take 1, 1's a 1. So here remainder comes 1. Then we have to put down the zeros. And since we have crossed the decimal, we will place one decimal symbol here. Now this one value will be added. So it comes 1 plus 1, 2. Now we have to take one value here such that we have to multiply with the same value and the answer comes either equals to 100 or less than 100. So if we take 23, 3's a, so it comes 69. But if we consider 24, it comes 4 times 16, 96. So 96 is very close to 100. So we will take 4. So whatever value we take here, we have to multiply with the same value. So 24, 4's a, 96. So remainder is 4. Again this 4 will be added. So 24 plus 4, 28. Then this decimals will be copied. So it comes 400. Now if we multiply, now if we take 2, so it comes 282, 2's a, so it comes 564, which is more than 400. So we have to take lesser value. So we'll take 1. So it comes 281. So we'll take 1, multiply with the same value. Then we get 281. Then we will do the subtraction here. It comes 9. Here 1. Here also 1. So now the value is 119. Again we will put the decimals. Now this 1 will be added here. So it comes 282. So again we have to consider a value. So if we take 4, 282, then we will put 4 and multiply with 4, we will get 4 for the 16, then it comes 9, 11296. So it comes 11296, which is closest to 11900. So we will do the subtraction. So it comes 406. Now we will take more decimals here. And so on we will carry down. Now we have considered 4, 4 times. So now again we have to add 4 here. So it comes 2828. Now if we take 2 here, then we have to multiply with the same value, 28282. So it is coming 56564, which is very close to 60400. So we will consider 56564. Here we have to place 2. Then this 2 will be added here. It comes to 8284. Now the subtraction part, 6. So it comes. Now this comes 3. So from these upcoming values 1.4142 and it goes on, so we can say that it is non-repeating as well as not terminating. It is non-terminating. So that means root 2 is an erase number. Now I will discuss about the alternative method to show that root 2 is an erase number. So this method is called contradiction method. We have to consider, we will take, let root 2 is a rational number. Like in case if we prove that we know that real numbers are either rational or irrational. So if root 2 is not a rational number, that means it is an irrational number. So we will prove here that root 2 is not a rational number. So that's why we have considered it as a rational number. So in case if root 2 is a rational number, then root 2 can be written in the form of p upon q. As we have discussed, rational numbers can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are coprime integers and q is not equals to 0. Now we will square both sides. So on squaring both sides, the square of root 2 is 2, square of p is p square, similarly square of q is q square. Here we are writing squaring both sides. Now this p square can be written as 2 multiplied by q square. So from this expression we can say that p square is divisible by 2. Why? Because p square can be expressed in the multiple of 2, so we can say that p square is divisible by 2. So we know that if square of any value is divisible by a fixed quantity, then its root will also be divisible by the same quantity. That means if p square is divisible by 2, then p is also divisible by 2. So we are considering as a equation 1. Since p is divisible by 2, so we can say, we can express, let p equals to 2 multiplied by k. Here k is any constant value. So since p is a divisible by 2, so p can be expressed in the multiple of 2. Now if we do the square, we will get p square equals to 2 to the 4 k square. Now in place of p square, from here we can write it is 2q square. So 2q square can be written as 4k square. Now this is 2q square equals to 4k square. So if we cut this 2 and 2, so we get q square equals to 2k square. So from here we can say that q square is also divisible by, q square is divisible by 2. Now the same thing, since q square is divisible by 2, so we can say that q is also divisible by 2. So from here we can conclude that p and q both are divisible by 2. So this contradicts our assumption that p upon q is rational, because p and q do not have any common factor other than 1. But here we can see that p and q have common factor, that is 2, which is other than unity, or you can say 1. So from here we can write this contradicts our assumption that p upon q is rational, that is p and q are coprimes. So from here, since p upon q is not rational, that means root 2 is also not rational number. Therefore, we can say root 2 is an irrational number. So here is the assignment provided. In case of any query, you can ask. Thank you.